Welcome back to another video. Today we will talk about does alien exists. Let's get into the video. The numbers suggest that aliens exist. In terms of probability, it's reasonable to think that there is alien life somewhere in the universe. There are 300 billion stars in our galaxy alone, with new planets being discovered traveling around them. There are around 4,000 exoplanets just in our galaxy. When we consider the fact that there are around 200 billion galaxies in the universe as a whole, it would be short-sighted to assume that life only exists on Earth. We have already discovered hundreds of planets which could harbor life. A technique called spectroscopy allows us to measure the atmosphere of exoplanets to see if they contain the same kind of substances that appear in Earth's atmosphere. While this doesn't confirm that there's alien life, it does highlight that it's possible. Even on Earth, life exists in places we previously thought impossible. We've found microbes surviving in places on Earth where it was otherwise thought impossible. Life forms based on familiar DNA have been discovered deep in the ocean, in trenches untouched by sunlight. While the assumption has been that life can only exist on a planet within a certain distance from its local star, the discovery of life on Earth in places where it was hitherto inconceivable hints at the possibility that other places in the universe, for instance moons, may be able to support life too. Life elsewhere in the universe may not be intelligent life. While many scientists are optimistic about finding life elsewhere in the universe, it's not a given that it'll be intelligent life. It's only a small fraction of Earth's history that has featured intelligent life. For billions of years, our planet was home to very simple bacterial life. For alien life to contact Earth, it would have to be very advanced. Even if intelligent life forms exist, their conditions may make it difficult to contact us. Despite 300 billion stars, multiple solar systems, and around 10 billion years in which a civilization may have formed in our galaxy, there are lots of other important factors we must consider. Our only example of life to base judgments about aliens' life on is the life that exists on Earth. With this in mind, astronomer Maggie Adarin-Pocock thinks it's important for us to think outside the box. For example, she poses the idea that planets near active stars may harbor life that exists below the ground, which would make more it difficult to detect. The methods we're trying to use to communicate may be in opposition to potential life forms. Since the 1960s, we've used radio telescopes to look out for signals from extraterrestrial civilizations. However, these depend on civilizations using similar technology, and this is just one of many ways that a life form could send signals. This opens up the possibility that we may not have hit upon the right method. As stars are so far away, it could take years for a message from extraterrestrial life to reach us. Some stars in the middle of the Milky Way are 25,000 light-years away. This means that a message sent from this region would take around 25,000 years just to reach us, so even if there is alien life out there, the vast distances involved present an obstacle. Contact with alien life would require that it exists at the same time as us. While it's possible that extraterrestrials have attempted to contact Earth, it could have occurred at any time before humans existed, meaning we just aren't aware of it. If both civilizations don't coexist, then we'll never meet the aliens. We may have already missed them, or they may appear in the future when human life has come to an end. We're not yet capable of long-distance space travel, and this may also be the case for any alien civilization. We can't yet send a large spacecraft between the stars. The most we can do is send radio waves at the speed of light. Stephen Hawking was an advocate of Breakthrough Starshot, a project which is exploring the possibility of using a solar sail to send objects into our solar system. However, this would only travel at 20% of the speed of light, and with current technology, we'd only be able to send something with a maximum weight of a gram. If extraterrestrials do exist, they may have no inclination to visit Earth. Even if alien civilizations with the capacity to communicate with Earth exist, they may have no inclination to do so. That's it for today's video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click down below. Signing out.